A prerequisite for generating cross-sections is to have a model. When the model is created, the tool can be found in the Scene 3 Tools tab. When the tool is activated, it opens a widget that is similar to the orthoprojection widget. Besides the usual editing options, this widget allows us to set up the cutting plane direction. By default, the cutting plane is set to be horizontal, but by clicking on these squares, we can change the direction. At the same time, the widget displays a ruler that allows us to see a preview of the cross-sections by hovering the mouse cursor over the ruler. The first cross-section starts here from the starting point that is indicated by these red arrows. Now let's take a look at the cross-sections panel. The cross-sections panel in the 1DS is very simple. It has only one setting that can be changed. And that is the distance between cross-sections. The value is in the project coordinate system units, so in our case, meters. Based on the interval, RealityCapture will calculate the resulting number of cross-sections. When the interval is changed, also the ruler is updated in the 3D view. So if we type in 10 meters, the resulting number of cross-sections will be 22. When we are satisfied with the preview, we can create them. After the computation, we can disable the tool and turn off the visibility of the mesh so we can see them better. We can also disable the cameras by pressing Ctrl E. They are automatically displayed after the computation, but if we would like to disable or re-enable them later, they are a child object of the model and they can be found here in the 1DS. They can be turned on or off by clicking on the eye icon, same as the mesh. If we select them, we get a new option to change the display step of the already computed cross-sections. Right now, every cross-section is being displayed. If we change the step to 2, only every other cross-section will be displayed. Cross-sections also work with the clip-in box. They can be exported from the Mesh Model tab, Scene 3D Tools tab, or through the new One Export. Cross-sections can be exported to CAD software in DXF format or to GIS software in shapefile format.